Here in female reproductive unit, we'll be taking a look at sexually transmitted infections. It would behoove you to take a look at your microbiology as well, so you know the details about some of the organisms that I shall be diving into. We'll begin our discussion by looking at important topic of vaginosis. There'll be three different families of vaginoses that you'll be responsible for: fungal, bacterial, protozoal. Our topic here first begins with the fungal, candidal infections. 10% of women are carriers of vulvovaginal fungi, 10%. The white patches is what you expect to find, but that should be of no surprise because wherever candida is infecting you, you would expect to find white patches. Here, the discharge that the female would be having would be called leucorrhea, and along with this, there is pretty intense itching that is accompanied with it. The predisposing factors in which your patient will be developing candidal infection would be, well, what if there was increased glucose for the organism to munch upon? Welcome to diabetes mellitus. Also, oral contraceptives in pregnancy may enhance the development of the infection. Now, what you need to keep in mind is, I showed you earlier, a normal cervix. And whenever there's an infection, that cervix will then appear as being fiery red. Fiery red. So the underlying tissue will be infected and so therefore undergo an inflammatory process, and that will be red. However, the actual substance that is being secreted will be leucorrhea and white. What you're looking at here upon your wet mount would be pseudohyphae. Remember, these fungi do not contain true hyphae. They are yeast that have been then elongated, and so therefore you call this pseudohyphae. That is an important description. You either know it by description or you know it by picture, as you see here in the image.